Hi everyone, this is Deekshit. Welcome to my channel. In this particular video, I'll be talking about monitoring Kubernetes cluster with KLK stack. In one of my previous videos, I've spoken about Kubernetes monitoring using Prometheus and Grafana. So there are a couple of methods like by using Prometheus and Grafana, ELK stack, and there are many other monitoring ways also, but it depends on your requirement, which one you want to, which metrics you want to monitor. But in case like if you take Prometheus and Grafana, so it gives our nodes health and how many nodes are there, how many pods are there, how many stopped pods are there or something like that. So in that case, if you want to only monitor these kind of things, so then you can go ahead and you can use a Prometheus and Grafana by which you can see the metrics in your Grafana. Okay. But when you deploy application to a Kubernetes cluster, so basically it's a pod. So pod might be failed or it might be restarted because of many issues, because it might not be satisfied with liveness or readiness probe. So in that time, it is restarted or due to some application issue. So it has been, pod has been restarted or recreated. So the logs of that previous pod state was gone, right? So when you're dealing with the application, so it is always like a good thing that if you have some centralized logging system, that is a better thing, right? So that's the reason. So ELK stack is the one of the way by which like we can store our logs onto a centralized system wherein we can visualize the logs, why our pod has been deleted or why it has been failed. It can be many things like application failure or a liveness or readiness probe failure or a network issue. It can be anything. So that's the reason. So logs are always plays an important role. Okay. In this scenario, what I'll be doing, so I'll be taking the data, basically log files. Logs of Kubernetes cluster and the nodes by using beats, basically file beat and a metric beat. So I'll be using those beats, and those beats will have the data which will be directly can be forwarded to Elasticsearch actually. So because it is already formatted, that Elasticsearch needed. Okay, so you can directly send it, but in my case, what I'm doing, I'm just using a logstash as it is a demo. So I'm using a logstash. So what I'll be doing, file bits is there, right? So I'll be taking that input, the file bits input to logstash. Then I'm doing some manipulations and then I'm sending it back to Elasticsearch. Okay. So basically logstash is the bridge between bits and Elasticsearch. Okay. And the next one is, so in another bit like metric bit, so it is used to collect the cluster information. So from that, like I'm directly sending data to Elasticsearch. Okay. And now we have all the data which is related to our containers and applications and then our systems also in Elasticsearch, right? Now, if you want to visualize properly, then we need to have some visualization tool. In this, I'm taking Kibana. So all these tools are like from Elastic organization. So Elasticsearch, Kibana, Logstash, all file beat, metric beats are from the same company, same organization. Okay. Now, so let us see a brief about individual tool. So FileBeat. So the FileBeat is a lightweight shipper for forwarding and centralizing a log data. Installed as an agent on our servers, FileBeat monitors the log files on a location that you specify. That means when you install this particular application in the FileBeat configuration file, whatever the file or whatever the location you'll specify, that will be monitor. Okay. So every time, like if any changes are there, like it will collect that logs and then it is forwarded to Elasticsearch or a logstash for indexing. Okay. So I can directly send it to Elasticsearch, but as it is a demo, I just wanted to use logstash also in between. So that's the reason. So I'm sending file beat, the data, whatever the file beat collections, log collections will be forwarded to logstash. There I'll be indexing it and then I am forwarding it to Elasticsearch. Okay. And the next one is metric beat. So metric beat is a lightweight shipper that you can install on your servers to periodically collect the metrics from the operating system and the services running on the server. So file beat is like monitor only the log files or a particular file or a particular folder. But when it comes to metric beat, so it gives a metrics of all your operating system, basically the core operating system and the services running on it. Okay. So metric beat takes metrics and statistics that it collects and ships output to any one of them, like Elasticsearch or Logstash. In my case, I'm directly sending you to Elasticsearch. Okay. So the next one is Logstash. So Logstash acts as a bridge between, in my case, a Filebeat and Elasticsearch. So Logstash is a lightweight and open source server-side data processing pipeline that allows you to collect the data from variety services. In my case, it's Filebeat, and then transforms on the fly. So it takes input in one format, and then it'll do some manipulations, and then it'll send it to the destination. Okay. In most of the cases, like, it is used with Elasticsearch, because like some data might not be compatible with the Elasticsearch, right? So those kind of data, you'll give it to Logstash, then it'll do some manipulations, and then it is sent to Elasticsearch. Okay. And then the next one is Elasticsearch. So all the data we have collected from Filebeat or Metricbeat, and the process data from Logstash, we need to keep it somewhere, right? So that is the place Elasticsearch is. Elasticsearch is a distributed and open source search and analytic engine for all types of data, including textual, numerical, and geospecific, structured, and unstructured. Okay, in my case, I'm using Elasticsearch for centralized storage. Okay, and it is one of the main component. It is a central component. It attaches like Kibana and the source input things, right? So that's the reason it is a central component of Elasticsearch. So Elastic Stack is basically ELK stack. E for Elasticsearch, L for Logstash, and K for Kibana. Okay. And the next one is Kibana. Kibana is basically a visualization tool. Kibana is also an open source data visualization dashboard for Elasticsearch. It provides a visualization capability on top of content indexed on Elasticsearch cluster. Okay. And you can also create lines, bars, and scatter plots, and pie charts, and many more. So, but if you compare it with Grafana, so I mean, to set up a dashboard in Kibana is a little complex. Okay. And then we'll see the demo in the next video. Please do watch it. I'll leave a link in a description for Kubernetes monitoring with Grafana and Prometheus. If you have liked the video, please share and subscribe. Thank you.